me show you a trick. Follow the coin. It's in my right hand, now it's in my left hand, now I snap my fingers, and it's gone. You might say, well, it's still in your right hand, and you would be right. Except for it's not. The coin is actually right here. And you are blind. Not completely and not all of the time, obviously, but still, sometimes you don't see what is right in front of your eyes. And it's more often than you think. Let me show you. Count how many times the football hits the nets. The correct answer is 7, but did you see the monkey and the banana? How about the football changing its shape? Did you see anything else? In fact, there are a total of 10 different changes in this small animation, and I'm sure that you missed at least some of them. The question is why? Why sometimes we miss what is right in front of our eyes? Your eyes move 4 times a second, jumping from one object to another and scanning for new information. Even right now, your eyes are probably jumping within my eyes, mouth and hands. These jumps are called saccadic movements and are used to register mostly stationary objects. It's necessary because you can see in detail only a small portion of your view, the size of around your thumb and arm length away from you. So in order to make sense of the environment, your eyes have to constantly jump in different places and gather new information. However, sometimes you need to lock your eyes on a fast-moving object, like the football I showed you. Then your eyes can't just jump around, they need to stay focused on the target. That's when smooth pursuit takes place. Your eyes are moving slower, but they're fixated on the target continuously. As a result, you have a very clear vision of a small moving object, but you don't really see anything else. And that's the point. We can only see what we are focused on. And we can focus only on so many things. We pay attention to the most important information and we almost completely ignore the rest. Even right now, if you close your eyes, are you able to tell what I'm wearing right now? Perhaps not, because you are focused on what I'm saying and my constantly moving hands, rather than on my clothes. In the animation of the balls, you are focused on the football and you might have missed the monkey simply because you didn't focus on it and you didn't expect it. This phenomenon is called inattentional blindness, and it takes place when we don't see something simply because we are focused on something else. A famous example of this phenomenon is a study by Daniel Simmons and Christopher Chabris. In the studies, there was a video where a few people were passing ball between each other. Participants were asked to count how many times the ball was passed. In the middle of the video, a huge gorilla walked just in the middle of the scene. Surprisingly, only 50% of the participants realized that there was a gorilla. I used the same trick on you when I ask you to follow the football. Now you might think it was kind of tricky because all of the objects had similar shapes and size and the colors were kind of similar, so maybe they just simply blended in. But the opposite is true. The more salient and distinctive the unexpected object is, the more likely we are to miss it. On the other hand, if objects are similar, we are more likely to notice them. That's why in the animation, most of you probably saw the second football passing by, but not necessarily the coin, even though both of them were on the screen for a similar amount of time. This mechanism evolved for a reason. Your brain is constantly bombarded by multiple sounds, smells, and images, and it's impossible to process all of it at once. That's why your brain has to pick what to pay attention to and what to ignore. Imagine there is a lion walking around you. You want to pay attention to the lion, and you don't really care about the giraffe in the background. It's a survival mechanism. Unfortunately, sometimes we miss some very important information just because we didn't expect them. Every year, thousands of motorcyclists die in accidents with cars simply because the car driver didn't notice the motorcycle. Drivers often look only for the cars on the road and they can miss motorcycles the same way you miss the coin or the monkey. Yet, that's not the only way our brains can become blind. Let me show you another example. Follow the butterfly moving around. Now look at the same video, but focus on this one flower. Did you see it blurred this time? It's the same video, but you didn't see it the first time, did you? This phenomenon is called change blindness, and it takes place when we fail to observe a very obvious change in our field of view just because, again, we are focused on something else. I use it in the ball animation as well. That's why you might have missed that some objects change the shape or the color total of 5 times. A famous example of this phenomenon is the door study by Daniel Simmons and Daniel Levin. Here, a pedestrian is asked by the researcher for a direction. Then, 2 people walking with the door separate the pedestrian and the experimenter. The experimenter is swapped for a different person. Surprisingly, only 50% of pedestrians realize the change. Interestingly, people tend to notice the swap better when the researcher is more similar to them. The theory says that we tend to categorize people as within our group or outside our group. By the group, I mean similar age, appearance, etc. If somebody is within our group and is similar to us, we tend to pay more attention to them and we are more likely to see any changes, like the swap. But if somebody is in a different group, our brains quickly categorize them by the group and don't pay attention to details. We focus on the necessary minimum and we don't care about the rest. Even today, did you see that I changed my clothes 4 times? And was my mic on the left or on the right? And when did I swap my oranges for milk? As you can see, our brains are far from being perfect. They miss a lot and they have very limited capacity. And we can't really change anything about it. But what we can do is be aware of our limitations and remember that the world is not the way we see it. Subscribe for more science and more magic. Consider subscribing for more science. No, science. Subscribe for more science. Consider subscribing for more science. More science, subscribe.